In this video, we are diving into the pathophysiology of dilated cardiomyopathy. Now, if you want more help with studying med-surg in nursing school, you will definitely want to download the free med-surg checklist that I've got for you. I popped that link down below in the description, so be sure to snag that. Now, let's get to the pathophysiology of dilated cardiomyopathy. Hey there, friend. My name is Christina Rufano from NursingSOS.com, and today in this video, we are going to cover the pathophysiology of dilated cardiomyopathy. And make sure that you subscribe to this channel and click the little bell icon so you don't miss out on a future video that I post here on this channel. Okie dokie, so dilated cardiomyopathy is all about the heart. The walls of the heart are thinning, they are dilating. See how that works? This is a dilated cardiomyopathy. So here's what's going on. And of course, I'm gonna break it down into easy steps for you to follow. So step number one of dilated cardiomyopathy is that there is a trigger that makes the heart weaker, like an infection or an autoimmune disorder, something like that. So something like this happens and it triggers the heart to say, I don't really like this very much. So the heart is having a harder time pushing out blood because it's now weaker. It can't do its job as well. So the heart is having a hard time pumping out that blood because of that trigger that has now weakened it. Now, what's going to happen is the heart has a decreased cardiac output. Now, this is step number two. So step number two is there is a decreased cardiac output. And this means that there's less blood being pumped out of the heart to the body. So because this poor little heart is weaker, it can't do its job as well. So it can't pump out as much blood. So that cardiac output decreases. And this makes the body very unhappy because the body isn't getting any blood, obviously. The heart can't do its job, so the body can't get enough blood. Okay, so the cardiac output is decreased now, and because the heart and the other organs are all BFFs, right? I mean, they just have each other's backs and they all work together. That heart looks at that and says, oh no, body, all of my organ friends, you guys are not getting enough blood. I'm so sorry. Here, let me expand a little bit. That way I can get more blood in there and hopefully pump more blood out to you because there will be more blood inside my heart. And now this leads us to step number three. The heart expands and dilates to try to fit more blood inside it, hoping that because there's more blood inside the heart, that it can push more blood out to the other organs that the body needs. So the heart is now trying to pump enough blood to the organs, even though it's weakened. So even though the heart is now weakened, it wants to keep pumping enough blood to all of its BFF organs to keep that cardiac output up. So in order to compensate for that weaker heart and pumping less blood, the heart is now going to dilate to allow more blood inside the heart, so hopefully it can pump the same amount of blood out. Does this make sense? If this is all making sense to you, write love in the comments below. I really want to make sure that I'm explaining all of this well for you, so write love in the comments below if this is all kind of clicking for you. And that, my friend, is the pathophysiology of dilated cardiomyopathy. Step number one, there's a trigger that weakens the heart. Step number two, there is a decrease in cardiac output, so less blood is going to the body. And step number three, the heart expands and dilates to try to fit more blood inside to try to keep that cardiac output up and keep the organs happy. Now be sure to download the free med-surg checklist that I've got for you. It's a step-by-step guide to studying med-surg in nursing school, so you do not want to miss it. It's gonna save you a ton of time. That link is down below in the description for you to snag it. And of course, if you want more help with learning about the cardiac system in nursing school, you will definitely want to dive into the NursingSOS membership community, where we have a whole cardiac course for you to check out. And as always, friend, thank you so much for watching this video. Now go become the nurse that God created only you to be. And I'll see you right back here next time on the Nursing School Show. Take care.